This training is brought to you by the Colorado Department of Public Health and Environment's Office of Public Health Practice, Planning, and Local Partnerships. The State Health Department's logo is seen at the bottom of each slide. This brief training will orient you to the Colorado Health Information Dataset, also known as CoHID. CoHID is a central website organized by the Colorado Department of Public Health and Environment, where you can find data from various data sources and programs. We will highlight a few of the many important data dashboards that are available to you through CoHID. After completing this training, you will be able to navigate the various dashboards available within the Colorado Health Information Dataset, explain which data are available from the dashboards and demonstrate how they can be accessed, select the appropriate data sources and geographic levels to inform local public health work at the community level. Now we will begin the live demonstration of the website. This is the homepage for CoHID. These dashboards are a source of data from statewide surveillance systems, hospitals, disease registries, the Census Bureau, and more. These dashboards allow you to explore and visualize data at a number of levels, often including regional and county level estimates. Some dashboards visualize data from a single data source, and others visualize data from multiple data sources. Each of these green tiles is a different data dashboard and takes you to specific data from varying data sources, as well as different information and resources by topic. Each of these green tiles is a link to a unique dashboard providing various data and information and resources by topics. If you are curious about additional information or what type of information is included from that link, you can click the blue box underneath each of the green tiles to get a sentence or two describing what you'll find from that link. And that can save time from clicking on all the different links and having to dive and navigate each of them. We're now going to begin a demonstration of some of the vital records data dashboards. And this is for death or mortality data. Recently, the Census Bureau updated the way they represent race and Hispanic origins, and you have the choice of three different ways to view the vital records data. So on this webpage, you can see your three options from the three blue tiles in the center of the dashboard. We will click on this one for today. This dashboard has a similar template in the way that the graphics and information are laid out that you will find from many of the other dashboards on CoHID. You have the option of looking at the data by multiple statistics types, so counts, crude rates in the middle, and this third tile on your right presents age-adjusted rates. Right now, we'll look at counts. From this drop-down menu, you can select all causes of death, or you can look at categorical types of death, or even specific types of death. We'll leave it at all causes for now. On the right side of the drop-down menu, you'll find a slider bar, and this can be used to adjust the number of years to include and which years to include. So I've selected to include 2011 through 2021. Scrolling down, above the map, you'll find the total number of deaths from the cause of death that you selected. So we're saying all causes of death. So in this instance, there are 419,340. On the right is an age breakdown, a bar graph showing the age breakdown. below the age breakdown is the breakdown by sex. Below sex, you can view the data by veteran status. And lastly, the last demographic variable you can view is marital status. Scrolling back up, we'll look at the map. From the map, if you scroll over each county, additional information pops up in the tooltip or the box. If you select and click on one of the counties, then the rest of the visualization, the graphics on the right side, adjust and show and display the data only for that county. And continuing towards the bottom, you will find the trend line, the counts over time. And as you can see, for vital records, we have several decades of data available. I'm scrolling back up to the top, and I'd like to show you briefly from another statistic. So we just viewed counts. Now we'll select the blue tile on the right and see it presented as age-adjusted rates. So you'll see a very similar layout to what we just viewed under the counts option, but now we're looking at rates. We have the ability to select and change the cause of death. We have the slider bar to the right with the ability to change the years included. And so I'm selecting the same number of years, 2011 to 2021. We have the Colorado map by county on the left side. On the right side, we have the overall age-adjusted rate. Below that, you can find a couple demographics. On this one, we're seeing sex. And at the bottom, we have the trend line. Now I'm going to go back to the CoHID main page, where we can find additional dashboards that I'd like to demonstrate for you. Now I'm going to show you a substance use related page, and you can find this link from the fourth row in the middle with the title drug overdose. So when you click on this, it opens up this dashboard. There are three types of data sources from this dashboard. We have mortality data for drug overdose deaths. In the middle, we have the option to view hospital admissions and emergency department visit data. The data from the third box on the right in the blue box is from the Prescription Drug Monitoring Program, also known as PDMP. Today, I'm going to demonstrate from this middle box, the green box, showing hospitalization data. Each of these types of data presents three types of statistics, either counts, crude rates, or age-adjusted rates. Again, this is similar to what we saw on the vital statistics page, having three types of statistics to view. I'm clicking on the age-adjusted rates for the hospitalization data, and it opens up this dashboard, which has a very similar, follows the similar template to what we viewed in the vital statistics page previously looking at death data. We have a few more menu options from the top of this dashboard. You can select the type of geography you'd like to view, either by county or for a health statistics region. You can select which type of hospitalization data, either emergency department or hospital admissions. And then from the third bar drop-down menu, you can select all drug overdoses, or you can select specific types of drug overdose. Similar to what we've seen, we have the ability on the right side to adjust the selected years included using the slider bar. So for now, I will select 2018 through 2021. I left our menu options at county of residence for geographic view, and I also left the hospital admissions as the default data that we're viewing, and for all drug overdose. On the right side, the age-adjusted rate for our selections is presented. Below that, we have a demographic by gender. Looking at the map, when we scroll over each county, the tooltip box pops up and you can find several additional pieces of information describing the data that we're looking at. Below the map is a trend line where you can find the trend for the years that you selected from the scroll bar at the top. On this dashboard, you'll find a yellow question mark on the bottom left side. When you click on that, it will open up a PDF that has additional information that we refer to as metadata. Scrolling through the PDF, it has definition information, it provides background information and resources for each of the data sources used on this dashboard, and has relevant links, methods, and calculations for the data that we're viewing on the dashboard. So now I'm clicking back to the data dashboard. To the right of the department logo is a feedback box. When you click on this, you can complete a form providing feedback, contact information if you have questions, and any other information you'd like to share with the authors and program of this dashboard. Now I'm going to navigate back to our homepage, to CoHID, to their main page. We're going to look at one more dashboard. We're going to go look at immunization data for schools and childcare, which is the middle green tile in the third row. When you click on that link, a page similar to this will open up. And we're going to look at it for childcare, school, and community partners. So I'm selecting the middle link available. Our previous two dashboards looked very similar and had a very similar template in the way that they were laid out. I'm showing this dashboard because it is different and follows a different template that meets the needs for this data source and for the users of this information. So here we're looking at statewide view of school and childcare data immunization. You can select school, kindergarten, childcare. These are all menu options from the band in the middle. The next band available has different options for selecting years. So we will look at kindergarten for years 2020 and 2021. And it presents the data in bar graphs below. You'll find the counts, the percent, and the total number of students in the middle with a key. And we have the option of looking at the immunized population by the specific type of immunization, the proportions of exempted, and the proportions of non-compliant. At the bottom, you'll find two tree maps. On the left side are the exemptions as a percentage of total. And on the right side, you find compliance with the law. At the top of this dashboard, you can select different types of information or different types of visualization. So now I've selected the maps option. And so we can look at the different types of maps by school year and by the survey type. We can look whether we can change the parameters of what we're looking at. So right now it defaults to fully immunized, and we can change it to total exemptions by county. And it will update the map when I've clicked on total exemptions. One feature I'd like to point out that is on all of our dashboards is this download image at the very bottom right corner. When you click on that, you can select what format you would like to download. I clicked on image, and it will open up a photo image, and you have the ability to copy and paste this into a report, a presentation, a slide deck that you're working in. And all of our dashboards on CoHID have this option, which can make it nice because you don't have to recreate any of the visuals in other software. You can use them straight from our website. Next, I'm going to go back to our homepage, and I want to show you a few other resources available from CoHID that are not just dashboard links, but additional information that we have. Scrolling down, almost towards the bottom, the geospatial data and mapping tools. There are four links here that take you to maps that are already created, and you have the ability to change the data layers and what you're viewing in the map, as well as several links that have files with data layers and geospatial data for you to create your own maps. At the very bottom of our CoHID page are two important links. The data request system, if you click on this system, will take you to a form to complete. This is helpful if you have gone through several of the dashboards and you're unable to find the data that you're looking for or you're interested in, or you'd like to see it differently than the way it's been visualized on the dashboard. You can click on the data request system, submit your information in a form, and then a CDPHE staff member will follow up with you to get you that data. From the publications link, you will find, I'm clicking on the publications link, you can find a bunch of reports and infographics and other resources where data have been analyzed by topics. It can be really helpful to see data that are already analyzed for a specific topic, can help you think about ideas for how you'd like to present that information, or help you to figure out how to request information that you'd like to use. And it can also be a place where you can find additional statistics. Let's review the course objectives one more time. Now that you have taken this training, you will be able to navigate the various dashboards available within the Colorado Health Information Dataset, explain which data are available from the department and demonstrate how they can be accessed, select the appropriate data sources and geographic levels to inform local public health work at the community level. Take some time to explore the CoHID site further. There is so much data and information to uncover about your community. These tools can be used to enhance your understanding of the unique needs and makeup of your community members, support grant applications, assess the health of your community, and support a variety of other data needs you may have. Thank you for watching the Introduction to the Colorado Health Information Dataset training video. For more information on other data resources available through CDPHE, please visit the OPHP training website.